Hi students, in today's session I am going to discuss about trick to find Van 't Hoff factor from solution chapter class 12 chemistry. Suppose x particles of Na plus and x particles of Mg2 plus are present and both have same properties. See here, the properties which depends only upon the amount of the substance but not on their nature. These kind of properties we call it as colligative properties. If the number of particles changes, colligative properties also changes. If number of particles are same, colligative properties are same. If you dissolve a particular solute or an electrolyte in a solvent, if it is undergoing either association or dissociation, the number of particles changes. If number of particle changes, colligative properties also changes. See here, AB if it dissociates into A plus and B minus, number of particle changes. So colligative properties also changes. It is irrespective of whatever it is. It depends only upon the ions. And here A plus is combining with B minus and it is forming AB, means it is associating. After association, the number of particles decreases, so colligative properties also changes. And that time Van 't Hoff introduced a factor called I, which is useful to calculate the colligative properties. Van 't Hoff factor I is equal to total number of particles after dissociation or association. Suppose AB is dissociated into 2. So what is the number of particles after dissociation? 2 divided by total number of particles before dissociation is how many? 1. So Van 't Hoff factor I is equal to 2 by 1, that is 1. And now let us discuss for dissociation. A moles of, 1 mole of A is there. It is dissociated to B, which is giving n moles of B. Initially, how many moles are there? 1 mole. When reaction is not started, it is not forming B, means it is 0. When reaction is not started. If reaction is started, how many moles of B is there? N moles of B is there. See, 1 mole of A is converting into n moles of B, right? And here I want to tell you one thing, that is about alpha, degree of dissociation. See here, degree of dissociation means some amount at equilibrium. Suppose if you see at equilibrium, some amount of A, some moles of A converts into B. So what? Some moles of A converts into B. So suppose initially it is 100 moles, 25 moles are converting into B. So what you should do? 100 minus 25. Here alpha is a number of moles that is converting into B. What I do is minus of alpha. I do 1 minus alpha. Why? From 1 you should subtract this, because this is the amount which is converting into B. And here it is forming, so alpha. At equilibrium, what I do is 1 minus alpha. Understand students? 1 minus alpha, and this is n alpha of B is formed. What is the total number of particles after dissociation? Total number of moles actually. Total number of moles is 1 minus alpha plus n alpha. Clear? 1, just I am interchanging this to get the relation, 1 plus n alpha minus alpha. Just I interchange this, and what you do is take alpha is common, then you get n minus 1 into alpha. This is total number of moles or particles after dissociation or dissociation. Then what we know, that I is equal to this divided by total number of particles before dissociation. How many? 1. Then I is equal to 1 plus n minus 1 into alpha divided by 1. That is, I is equal to 1 plus n minus 1 into alpha. This is the relationship if it is undergoing dissociation. Let us discuss two cases under dissociation. One is for if it is a strong electrolyte, another one is for weak electrolyte. Case 1, for strong electrolyte. If it is a strong electrolyte, see here, to save the time I wrote here. If it is a strong acid like HCl, it is dissociated into H plus and Cl minus. What do you mean by strong electrolyte? strong electrolyte is the case where it undergoes complete ionization. 100% is the ionization. What do you mean by 100%? 100%, 100 by 100, which is equal to 1. Alpha, what is alpha value? 1. What is the relation we got, students? I is equal to 1 plus n minus 1 into alpha. Substitute the alpha value here. What is alpha? 1, right? So 1 plus n minus 1 into 1, which is equal to I. So I is equal to 1 plus n minus 1. Minus 1, 1 gets cancelled. I is equal to n. Means in the case of strong electrolytes, the number of ions is equal to Van't Hoff factor I. See here HCl, it's dissociated H plus Cl minus. What is the N value? 2. So I value also 2. HNO3 H plus and NO3 minus, 2 ions. So I value also 2. HClO4 H plus and ClO4 minus, I value is 2. And H2SO4 dissociated into 2H plus and SO4 2 minus ions it gives. Total number of ions is 3. So Van't Hoff factor also 3. Let us see for strong bases like NaOH, it gives Na plus and OH minus ions. What is the N value? 2. So Van't Hoff factor also 2. BaOH twice, it gives Ba2 plus and 2OH minus. What is the N value? 3. So Van't Hoff factor also 3. And here Na salts, all type of salts. NaCl gives 2 ions, so I value 2. K2SO4 gives 3 ions, so I value 3. Al2SO4 thrice gives how many ions? 5. So Van't Hoff factor I 5. And K4FeCN6, how many ions it gives? 5 ions, so Van't Hoff factor is 5. Let us discuss for weak electrolytes. Weak electrolytes, the case for both weak acids like CH3COOH, HCN, and weak bases like NH4OH, ammonia, what happens? See this question. Acetic acid is 10% ionized. Calculate Van't Hoff factor I. 10% ionized means what is alpha? 10 by 100, which is equal to 0.1. What is the formula to calculate I for dissociation? 1 plus n minus 1 into alpha. This is the formula. And substitute alpha value in this. I is equal to 1 plus n minus how much? Number of ions for acetic acid is CH3COOH. Because it is weak acid, right? For weak acid, it dissociates less. Number of ions is 2. 2 minus 1 into alpha is how much? 0.1. Then I is equal to 1 plus 0.1. That is 1.1. Means initially 1 mole is there, but after dissociation we are getting Van't Hoff factor 1.1. Why, students? Because I is total number of particles after dissociation is more. Numerator value is more than the denominator. That's why for dissociation we get always I greater than 1. Why I greater than 1? Because numerator is more. Number of particles after dissociation is more. Case 2. For association. Suppose n moles of A is there. N moles of A is associated into 1 mole. This is how many moles? N moles, and this is 1 mole. Okay. But at equilibrium, if you observe, some moles of A, that is converted into 1 mole, right? Means AN moles. AN. It is forming AN. So what I do is, alpha is the degree of dissociation, mean these many moles of A is converting into AN, and this is, it is forming alpha, right? And see here, one more thing I'll tell you, n moles of A is giving 1 mole. Then 1 mole gives how many? 1 into 1 by n. N moles is giving 1 mole, Then 1 mole gives how much? 1 mole gives 1 by n moles of An. Now at equilibrium what to do? It is 1 minus alpha. This is 1 by n into alpha. Clear students? What I did? Initially it is n moles. It is forming 1 mole. N moles gives 1 mole. Then a 1 mole gives how many moles? Then do the cross multiplication. You get 1 by n. Means 1 mole of A is forming 1 by n moles. This is the degree of dissociation. So what is the total number of moles? 1 minus alpha plus 1 by n alpha. Just I am rearranging this to get the relation. 1 plus alpha by n minus alpha. What to do is take alpha as the common. Then we get 1 by n minus 1 into alpha. This is I. I is number of particles after association how many? 1 plus 1 by n minus 1 into alpha divided by 1. This is for association. Now let us solve one question that acetic acid is dimerized in benzene up to 10%. Find Van 't Hoff factor I. See here, it is dimerized means association. What is the formula you have to use for association? I is equal to 1 plus n 1 by n minus 1 into alpha. For dimerized means what is the n value students? 2, because 2 moles of acetic acid. Dimerized means 2 moles are converting into 2 moles initially are converting into 1 mole. What is the n value? 2. And it is 10% it is dissociated. So alpha is 10 by 100. How much it is? 0.1. Substitute that here 1 plus 1 by 2 minus 1 into 0.1. That is 1 plus minus of 0.5 into 0.1. That is 1 plus 1 minus 0.05, which is equal to 0.95. This is the I value. If you observe the I value, it is less than 0.95. Why? Because denominator is more, means number of particles before association is more. That's why I value is less than 1 for association. Now let us see the summary, which is very very important students, easy to remember. See, I is equal to 1 plus n minus 1 into alpha. This is for dissociation. And what you have to do is I is equal to 1 plus this n place you take 1 by n. 1 by n. This n place 1 by n you take minus 1 into alpha. This is for association. Association. In the case of dissociation, greater than 1. In the case of association, less than 1. Less than 1. For non-electrolytes, I is equal to 1. Clear? I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching.